Now that we've calibrated the drill, let's talk a little bit about the row unit. At the front of the row unit, you will see the parallel linkage with the heavy-duty down-pressure springs. Currently, this is in the fourth position on these parallel links. The fourth position will give you 450 pounds of pressure at the pinch point. I've never used this drill in a no-till situation in the fourth position. Anytime I've ever used this drill in a no-till situation, I've always put it in the second unit. That's really all that you need. You're putting way too much pressure, way too much stress, way too much pressure on the blades and everything else if you put it in that fourth position. In a typical conventional till field where you're going to be planting in something that's already been disc up, harrowed up, something like that, you'd typically put it in the first position. Another question I regularly get is about these soil control devices. The soil control devices are UHMW plastic. It's a high molecular plastic. It doesn't wear very easily. And they come from the factory pretty well set. People ask, should I drag them on the ground? Should I leave them up in the air? No, typically you want to leave them where they're just above the ground. What they're doing is they're catching all the soil that's potentially blown out by the disc blades going in the ground. Anytime you put a disc blade in the ground and you turn it at an angle, it's going to move dirt. So the faster you run, the more dirt you're going to move. These soil control devices keep that dirt in that trench so you get good seed-to-soil contact. Next thing we need to discuss is the cam mechanism used to set the depth on the drill. Many people ask me, should I set it in A, should I set it in F, where should I set it when I first start out? I typically say C is about an inch deep, so you want to move it a little deeper towards D or a little shallower towards B. Each one of those notches is about a quarter of an inch. So that's going to kind of give you a guideline idea of how deep you need to set your seed based on what your conditions are. Lastly, I want to talk about the press wheel. The press wheel will swivel 10 degrees left, 10 degrees right. It is the only daily maintenance while you're operating the drill that you need to grease that every day, every 8 hours. The press wheel that I recommend is a 3x13 press wheel. It's double ribbed, meaning it's got a rib on both sides and it's got a soft center. What that does is gives you great seed to soil contact without giving you that additional pressure in the center with a crowned press wheel. The only other press wheel that I may recommend is that additional 4-inch press wheel that's double ribbed. The only reason I'd recommend that is if you're in very wet conditions the majority of the time that you're drilling and you needed that additional flotation.